Nate, we've been talking on the phone quite a bit about where do you start when you learn in leadership? Because, you know, it can get so complex that, well, what could I do right now to make the biggest difference, the biggest thing that help impact on those people around me? What should I learn? And I think I shared with you, I think that absolute must that we learn how to evaluate people. And I shared earlier, it's not about just psychoanalyzing them. It's, we're looking for some specific things that in evaluation, because we want to know how to position people. We want to know where you can assist them even being better, or are they even going to listen to you in the first place? Because if you're going to train them, you want them listening to you and learning. Right. And a lot of people will say certain things, and they're really not that. So who can you trust? Because trust is a key to a relationship. Your relationship is only as deep as the depth of the trust of the person. Okay? So in light of that, there's a couple things that I evaluate. And it's not that tough to... But I first evaluate, are they all about themselves? Or are they all about others? Now, this is a tough one because I've run into so many people that they look like they're all about themselves. When they would give you the shirt off their back to help you, but they are these gruff people, girls or guys, and it's just like no nonsense, and it almost looks like, oh, you're just a, you know, leading by intimidation, when really they'd help you do anything. So we cannot jump to conclusions there. We tend to jump to conclusions. So are they more about self or others? And it's real easy to ask certain questions to get that. Secondly, I look at, are they consistent? I don't care if they're consistently wrong. I want somebody that's consistent, because then you can turn that one around. They're consistently doing right now. Okay? But the people that are one way here and another way here, and it's like you don't know what you're really dealing with. Well, there's probably dishonesty involved there too. Okay? So consistent. And then I'm going to say the last one is tenacity. I'll just say they ride for the brand, okay? They're loyal. You can tie them up and take their name and everything away, and they still know what they're all about and who they ride for, who they're loyal to, okay? I look at that, you know, or are they just quitters, you know, that type of thing.
Yeah.
And it doesn't matter on age. It doesn't matter. So we put all these parameters on people, and yet we can find those things out very easy, and I'll come back to that in a little bit. The other thing I evaluate for when I get down to like specifics of training, when I train somebody, I'm looking at tasks. I have to evaluate how good they are, okay? Can they do it, and how good are they at it, okay? So I'm not trying to knock them down, but if I underlead them, you know, then they scare me after that. If I overlead them, I tick them off. I have to know how to come in and match the leadership skill that's needed. Uh-huh. Like if a person has a lot of experience, okay, and I start talking to them like a little kid, they're going to probably sit there and, you know, yes, 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 but it's going to really fry them, okay? Okay, but what if a person doesn't have much experience, but you thought they did? And so you just delegate something out to them. And it's like, oh, that's nice, because they're scared to death. I don't care how old they are. They're scared because they want to make you feel like they did the job. I want to define the word delegate, by the way. Delegate is so abused, but it does not mean that we give somebody the job to do because we don't want to do it, or because we just want to see if they can fail or something. You know, that's not funny. Delegate means that I give you the responsibility to make the decision as if I made it. I give you the responsibility of making the decision as if I made it. Now that means then I better know that they can make a decision as if I did. So that involves some training on how I think, okay?
Okay, it's more like the mindset of it? Or
mindset of it, how I arrived at making that. Now I didn't say that I want them to make the same decision, because their decision might have been the right one and I made a wrong one, okay? Mm-hmm. I want them to have the mindset and the thought processes of how they arrived there. Okay? That's what I care about the most. And it could be different than mine. It might be way better than mine.
Yeah.
I just care about that process of mindset, of thinking to get there. Okay? And so I want to know that before I delegate it. But so back to those types of evaluations. But for me, because I evaluate people specifically in my area for other leaders, because there's leaders of leaders and there's leaders of followers, okay? There are two different types of leaders, okay? I tell people that, yes, it's train the trainer, but it's more than that. Train the trainer to train someone else to train. Down the line, okay? Train the trainer to train someone else to train. Now you're carrying right through this pattern process and you're watching it develop, okay? But so I train trainers. So in my evaluation, I have to look at, are they self-centered or are they about others? That person there is going to be a learner if they're about others. They're going to be a listener too. Maybe not real skilled because they haven't practiced, but an inconsistency, that's character stuff. So I want to know the consistency of things. And I can ask just a couple of questions. I'll give an example. If I said, Nate, I want you to describe to me your hero, a hero of yours. Don't give a name. What would the character traits of that hero be? Whoever you describe is who you are. You see, you're going to align with people like you, your values and all that. You're not, so you just gave yourself away there. Okay, so that's just how easy it is. So I can get it down to real, you know, or describe your best friends that you hang around. What are their character traits? And just give me some examples of friends that you hang around. What makes them your friend?
Well, a couple that I can think of is, one, there's mutual interest.
Mm-hmm.
I obviously value them, but seeing that reciprocated, that they value me, just that's a big one. And some side things I've noticed is they're all pretty driven. They all not what you call traditional, more of just ambitious, wanting to get ahead, you know,
mm-hmm.
kind of get ahead. And so I feel like I've been attracted to those people, and naturally people kind of dissolve or we stay together depending
mm-hmm.
on, you know, how their values and their drive is, and if that really makes sense for me.
Okay. You just probably told me everything I need to know right there. Okay, you said they look out for you too. There's the, now just looking at the judge, okay. You said that, that they are persistent, okay? You said driven, but persistent, they haven't quit, okay? And also you explained to me a consistency. They are constantly thinking this way. So right there alone, you described those things right off the bat, okay? That's what I listen for, is that type of stuff. And we hang around people like ourselves, so I would know that you're like that too. You and I are around these people. So that's how, when I'm evaluating, then I have to evaluate, okay, to what level are they good at, you know, who would I take on as a leader then? Because then now you get down to the task thing, how long is it going to take me then to train them? But in evaluating people, when they talk, they give themselves away. Okay? There's a proverb, even a fool when he keeps his mouth shut is considered wise. Okay. When I get somebody to talk, they give themselves away.
Yeah.
But I need to know these things because I want to know where I put my efforts, because I'm responsible for my time. I'll use the word stewardship. Okay, I need to be a steward of the assets that I have. Time is one of those things. I want to get the most out of my life and time. Okay, so I can't just be, you know, hitting and missing on things either. And then I don't want to waste their time if they don't want to learn it.
Yeah.
Okay? So I look at things from even the investment perspective in how I organize who I talk to and different levels of learning that they are going to do. And we can talk a lot more about that, but evaluation of people. Do you have some things to add to that?
I know, this is great. It's okay. A lot. You know, I'm sure we'll have a discussion again in the future.
And again, the most important thing is, I'm saying this to you right now, but my job is to demonstrate it to you. When you see it, then you're going to learn the most, and you copy it. But I've got to demonstrate things with excellence. Again, shame on me for not training with excellence. So I have to practice all the time myself. And I believe that all of us need a coach or a mentor. We have to have that in order to really be successful. And I don't mean the money success. I mean success in our thinking processes, in being able to have critical thinking, this whole thing.